Now, we all know how ambitious open-world games are. There are many out there, and they are all fighting to get fans' attentions and to keep players hooked on the game. Some games, like Destiny, do it right, and some games, like The Division, lost their fan base pretty quickly. I am here to discuss a few key things that I feel that Anthem needs to do in order to survive in the market. Now, the first thing is very obvious, but sadly, it needs to be noted. Make sure the game's networking systems work on launch. There have been too many reports of multiplayer issues on launch. This isn't even specific to open-world games. First-person shooters have had this problem, sports games have had connection issues on launch, and many more. Many of you might remember how absolutely terrible it was trying to connect with your friend in GTA 5 when its multiplayer launched. For Anthem, to keep its fanbase right when they're excited and ready to play is to have as little issues with the connection as possible. A way that they can do this is have an open beta near launch, something so they can test the servers and prepare for how many players are going to be there on day one. As a quick side note before going into the second one, make sure the game is also not buggy. Again, should be obvious, but I feel like it needs to be said. The second thing that BioWare will need to do to keep their players playing Anthem is to give them a reason to keep playing. Once you finish the main story, the issue for many games is that there isn't anything else to really do. Mafia 2 is an example of this. It is a great and pretty fun open world game to play. But once you finish the story, there is nothing else to do, and many players stopped playing right there. For Anthem, they need to figure out ways to keep players playing the game. They could implement raids or dungeons similar to that of World of Warcraft and Destiny. Those keep the players going back to the game to play new raids or instances with their friends so they can complete them and get the almighty loot. Another is to give players a lot of freedom and quests. And that does sound difficult, but in Skyrim, they have a system where you will always get quests. It is impossible to complete every quest in Skyrim, so having a system like that in Anthem would allow the players to keep getting quests so they have reason to keep going around the map. And that's important. You want the players to continue playing the game, and it gives them a feeling of purpose as they go about helping those that are behind the wall. Now, to go hand in hand with the previous example, make the world interesting. You can have the most well-crafted story, but if the players aren't having fun or aren't interested in what's going on around them from going from point A to point B, they're not going to continue playing. You have to make sure that the world is interesting to the players. From what we've seen in the trailers, there are animals that we can interact with. Have those run around the world so the player might interact with them. Or, if they are huge, the player will have to go a different route. Have each area feel different, and not just a simple copy and paste of previous areas with a different skin. Make sure that each place is recognizable and unique. The underwater area, for example. Make sure that the areas feel unique to other underwater areas, and especially feeling unique than to those that are on land. Have the mountains feel completely different from the grasslands. Have the forest be thick and dense and have animals running about it. Make each area really feel different from every other place. And there are probably going to be hub areas around the map, so it is very important to make each hub area feel different from the others. An easy solution to this is have some hubs sell certain objects that the others won't. Have one area outside the wall sell materials that you can't get from a merchant when you're inside the wall. You can even go a step further and have the hubs look completely different. Maybe you have one in the center of the wall, it is high class. This is the area where there will be tall buildings and bright lights and so on. While near the exit of the wall, it's a bit more run down. Buildings are a bit decayed, everything looks a bit sketchy, but it still feels different. Another idea could be a hub outside of the wall could possibly be built within a cave and look very handmade with a few people there. Making each area cool and unique will make the players want to keep playing to see what else they might find. Another way to keep Anthem alive through its time is to always add new things. Rainbow Six Siege keeps adding new players to play as well as maps to check out. Overwatch keeps adding new skins and customization options for their characters. Destiny holds events that would allow the players to get new customization options. Anthem will need to do something similar to not just get fans interested, but to keep them playing the game months or even years after release. Now, of course, DLC is an option, and there will very likely be DLC for Anthem. But what I am meaning are events that get held that can allow you to get unique-looking items for your characters, either weapons, armor, or customization options. Now, the last one I want to go over is to make the game with the community in mind. Make the game enjoyable for both those who want to play solo and those who want to play co-op. A simple way you can have that work is have difficulty scale dependent on how many people are in the party. No one wants to be stuck in a mission because it is too hard because they went in alone. And same goes for those going in with a posse. You don't want to go through an area having it almost childishly easy because four of you are rolling in there. Or, if the game is open world, the same way that Destiny is, don't force the players to have to interact with others that they come across. Allow the players to play the way they want. If people are forced down a path, many will not be happy and they will leave. Another way, and this again is a very, very big thing that Anthem will need, is to make it easy for groups to form. There might be moments where my friends are busy but I want to do a raid, but I can't match up with people in the game and I have to go to websites or forums to find people. Have a system like in World of Warcraft where you say what you play as and it'll match you with others looking for a group. Also, in terms of microtransactions, either don't have them or have them be purely cosmetic. Now, we know that putting something into a game that increases profits is a good idea. But when it is something that fully changes how the game is played, many people won't like that. If the microtransactions are purely cosmetic, maybe allowing you to get a different color set on your javelin or different symbols and so on, that's fine. I might even throw a few dollars down myself for a nice brown-white combo. But if players have to spend money to get the best gun in the game or to get the best armor, that will make those who are looking at the game not want it. If it is a pay to win, that's gonna really kill the fan base. All in all, make sure that when you're creating the game, the community is who you have to have in mind. If you make the game with the community in mind, they will play the game for months or even years. So, what are your opinions on this? Do you have any ideas on how Anthem can keep its fan base once it's released? Let us know in the comments down below, and while you are there, give this video a like and hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video.